But first, the Pacific Leaders Forum has just ended in the Marshall Islands amidst concern that island countries are struggling to deal with an increasing number of disasters. Climate change has been the focus of this year's regional meeting, and joining us now with the latest is Pacific correspondent Barbara Drever. With the annual meeting now over, what are the major issues that the forum has decided to act on?
Well, look, climate change was always going to be the big issue here. It was the theme of the forum, and little wonder, because we're here in the Marshall Islands, of course, which has been badly affected by the impacts of climate change. Now, this declaration on the Marjoro Declaration on Climate Change, which the leaders have come up with, is a very strong declaration. It says that the Pacific countries are the most vulnerable and hit in this area, and therefore this region should be considered a global leader in this area. Now, tomorrow the forum countries are going to be asking their dialogue partners such as China, Japan and the US to sign this declaration, asking for greenhouse emissions to be reduced around the world. And then this declaration is going to be taken to the United Nations, to the Secretary General himself. And they're hoping that this declaration will be used to come up with a legally binding climate change document.
What are we seeing around the Pacific?
It's predicted that there's going to be catastrophic impacts on Pacific people in terms of their livelihood and security, and this is just climate change. And what you're seeing already in countries like Kiribati, Tuvalu and here in the Marshall Islands is the erosion of coastline. They are losing land to the sea. You're also seeing the contamination of some crops and contamination of groundwater. So a very serious situation for those low-lying islands. And in fact, I was talking to the Kiribati president, Anote Tong, and he believes that his country has 20 years before it has to consider its very serious options.
The forum's been divided about Fiji's suspension. Where do the leaders now stand on the issue?
Well, look, Pacific leaders are still very divided about Fiji. What they are united in, though, is that they do believe Fiji does need to return to democracy. It does need to hold elections. What they're divided about is when Fiji should be readmitted back into the forum. Not having Fiji here has impacted badly on countries like Tuvalu and Kiribati, who depend so much on Fiji for transportation. And also Vanuatu wants Fiji back into the fold. However, the consensus is they will have to hold elections before they're considered readmitting back into the forum.
There have been murmurings about the Pacific Forum being weakened. What's your impression?
Look, I think there's no doubt that this year, I've been covering forums for a couple of decades now, and I think there's no doubt that this forum, it's felt a bit unwieldy, a bit big. Pacific leaders work best on a one-to-one basis, and they certainly get that at the leaders' retreat. However, the forum itself does feel like that, and in fact the Vanuatu Prime Minister has told me that he indeed feels the same way. However, you know, you have to remember that Vanuatu Prime Minister was not here at the forum, nor was Australia, because they're holding their elections. But the leaders that were here, while it did feel a little bit fractured, the good news is when they come to meet on a one-to-one basis, they really come to the party, and you get a really strong declaration like the Marjoro Declaration on Climate Change. That is a good example of how well the forum works together.
Thanks, Barbara.